The Vice President Jessica Lupo says she is working together with the First Lady Janet Museveni, UNICEF and UNFPA to roll out a nationwide program against teenage pregnancies and early marriages, which has been escalated by COVID-19-induced lockdown. She appealed to civil society organizations to support the program to rescue the girl child.
In the very near future, I shall be seeking for your support in a practical way on how to go to the countryside, but also in the region, to see how to tackle the problem of teenage pregnancies, unwanted early marriages, and also child abuse.
Lupo was officiating at Regional Women's Political Leadership Convention in Kampala, which was organized by Akina Mama wa Africa to discuss strategies of uplifting women into positions of leadership.
In the spirit of empowering the African woman, therefore, I would like to invite all of you to continue celebrating the African woman during and after the 2 days convention. And I would like to recognize your very good comment on noting that in Uganda today, we are smiling in this convention because we are given the Vice President, we are given the Prime Minister, we are also given the First Deputy Prime Minister, and also the third deputy prime minister.
With a cabinet of 43% women and 46% women in local councils, women activists have applauded Uganda for moving steadily in achieving gender equality objectives and celebrated appointment of the second female vice president and the first female prime minister in the history of the land.
Women's political participation, Africa Barometer 2021, women constitute 24%. Of the 12,113 parliamentarians in Africa. Looking at those figures, you can see that as Uganda, we are doing better than that. And we want to congratulate the Vice President for their role in fighting. Of course, people like Miriam Atembe, who were also there before, Madam Mpanga has been speaking to us. So they've been there right from the beginning, the constitution. So we have a little more progress.
However, Akina Mama wa Africa called for more policies on affirmative action to increase the number of women in parliament.
Women cannot defy all odds and make it into positions of leadership. We want the government to create an enabling environment. So legal and policy frameworks, yes, are important. For example, why should we have a woman member of parliament in Uganda who represents a whole constituency? Then you have a male member of parliament representing a small area. So one of the proposals that the women's movement has made has been that we should simply have two members of parliament representing a district, have a female, have a male, and that's it, and that's enough.
Women activists expressed a great concern that politics is getting too much commercialized, which is depriving women from participation. They emphasized that a lot of women who aspire to join politics lack financial resources to run against their male counterparts.
Getting elected as a woman leader is not all, you know, no easy road for any woman. And there are many hurdles you have to jump over. One of the biggest is to engage with the society to accept you. The issue of acceptability is a big concern for many women because you have to deal with the socio-cultural perceptions. People think women cannot be good leaders. Up to today, those thoughts are still ongoing.
It is not a one-off activity. It is a journey, which journey must be walked by both men and women in order to reach where they want to reach, because it is for the benefit of both. You have to agree with me that, for instance, without women in this country, I'm telling you, I don't know where Uganda would be.
The 2021 general elections saw a number of female MPs on direct seats drop from 21 to 13. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.
I just want to go back to a few words, a few lines.